Everybody, Tim here with today's episode of Future Man, Season 3, Episode 2, There Will Be Borscht. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right. I just had to Google it, and okay, it's some sort of European soup that I've never once heard of, but it looked really gross and red. Anyway, so once again, the trio is basically just time crime fugitives running away. We learn, like, because we saw Seth Rogen, Susan, with the little tuft of red hair, and evidently that means something, because we now meet a new character who has, like, the green hair, and it's great, because she's like, I was born from a vagina. I wasn't born fully formed as an adult, and, like, Seth Rogen's like, ew, why would you say that word? It sounds so gross. It is just, it's absolutely amazing. It was really funny. So first, like, the three of them go to France, and Wolf ruins everything by inventing bread too early, and then they go to Japan. It's like 820 AD or something, and they're there for a while, and we learn about the Big Suck, which, how do you say that without laughing? And it's basically, like, all of the timelines are kind of like almost like there's a black hole in the middle and they're kind of mixing. There's actually, I think, a Transformers episode about that where, like, dinosaurs show up. But anyway, and so all of the timelines are slowly starting to mix together. And so they're trying to get around. Of course, Wolf falls in love with some woman. Tiger just wants to kill people, and they're trying to figure things out, but it's not quite working. They're sending the 299 after them, based off of the 300, but nobody wants the Hunchback. And I was like, that's kind of fucked up, but I gotcha. Okay, whatever. And so, once again, they're on the run, and as the episode ends, they end up with what appears to be Native Americans. I'm not sure where it's going, but I'm super excited. I mean, the episode itself wasn't fantastic, but it was still kind of interesting to watch, like, Susan and his timeline looking for the criminals and watching Wolf, Tiger, and Josh just run away as fast as they can. So I'm still super into this season. I believe this is the last season, which is really sad, but curious what you guys think. Let me know, and I will see you guys next time for Trapper's Delight.